In a small town in northern Ontario, the year 1922, Green Case first learned of a cancer remedy which she termed Essiac.
All'insaputa della storia, questa fragile nurse canadese è eroicamente riuscita a curare migliaia di persone dal cancro con un semplice decotto di erbe. Nel curare un'anziana paziente, René notò che aveva una cicatrice sul seno. La paziente spiegò che erano i resti di un tumore che era riuscita a guarire molti anni prima con un decotto di erbe che gli aveva suggerito il saggio della locale tribù degli Ojibwa. René provò la stessa formula sulla zia, a cui avevano da poco diagnosticato un cancro.
I asked Dr. R.O. Fisher, who later was Dean of the University of Toronto, if he would watch over her, if I would try some of these herbs. And he said he would. And it took quite a while, but she got better. And she lived for 21 years.
Dopo quell'esperienza positiva, René lasciò l'ospedale e si mise a curare la gente con il decotto di erbe che in seguito avrebbe chiamato Essiac. Essiac è il suo cognome scritto al contrario. La voce si sparse rapidamente e il numero dei pazienti guariti dal cancro iniziò a moltiplicarsi.
About 1943, I was diagnosed in Toronto General Hospital as having a growth in the bowel which was inoperable. And that was in January, and my husband was told that when the snow was gone, I would probably be gone with it. So through friends, I was directed to Miss Case, and I came to her and had treatments from her for practically 3 years and felt I was cured, and I've had no return of it since.
Dr. R.O. Bastida of Bracebridge sent me a patient of cancer of the bowel, Bert Rosen, and I cured him. So Dr. Bastida went before the town council and mayor and persuaded them to give me a building that they had taken for taxes as a clinic. That I had made a great discovery and that I should be supported in my own hometown. So they set up the clinic where I treated for 8.5 years.
Dopo pochi mesi, la clinica era piena di malati venuti da ogni parte del Canada.
Our clinic would be full every time we were there. And there were people came in ambulances who were not able to come in for a treatment. She would have to go out and administer the medicine out in the ambulance. Then as the time went on, we watched these people be able to walk in. And finally, they were driving their own car to get SCI.
I treated from 300 to 600 patients a week. And the only way they would allow me to do this was free of charge, and I had to have a doctor's diagnosis for every case I treated.
So we brought the diagnosis to Nurse Case, and I took treatment from her every week for about a year. And I have no cancer today.
Fu un certo dottor Leonardo di Buffalo che aveva capito il potenziale esplosivo della cura di René ad avvisarla di quello a cui sarebbe andata incontro.
Dr. Leonardo, he was a cancer surgeon, and he said, "You think you have a cure for cancer?" I said, "I'm way beyond thinking. I know." Then I had 5 other doctors in the examining patients, and he asked if he could go in with them and examine patients, and I told him he could. So then he told me, he said, "You have it, but the medical profession will never let you do this to us."
Poco dopo, un misterioso gruppo di investitori si presentò da René offrendo $1 million per avere la formula del decotto. ma lei rifiutò l'offerta, poiché non le veniva garantito che la cura sarebbe stata resa disponibile gratuitamente per chiunque ne avesse bisogno.
Green Case was called before the legislature in 1938 to determine Essiac's legal status.
I was trying to legalize my treatment, and the patients went out and got this petition signed, 55,000 names on it. And I went before the legislature, and I lost out by 3 votes.
Public outcry forced the establishment of a cancer commission to investigate herbal remedies. The greatest majority of Reen's evidence was rejected.
You see, they said the doctors all made mistaken diagnosis, that that's why the patients thought they were cured.
I kept on my clinic as long as I could, until they stopped the doctors from giving a diagnosis, and then I had to stop. And it's a sad thing when somebody comes and they have somebody that is ill with cancer and the medical profession can do nothing for them, and they beg of me to treat them. It's a very, very sad thing to turn them away.
And I had a nervous breakdown over that,
so I really had to stop.
I don't see how they can refrain from recognizing it, because if you have the proof, you have the diagnosis from the doctor, you have the pathological findings, and you find you have the living patient to show that they are still alive after the medical profession has given them up. And yet they refuse to admit that it is a cure.
Dopo essersi ripresa dall'esaurimento, René ricominciò da zero, preparando il decotto e curando i pazienti nel proprio scantinato.
I have to grind them. I used to get them already ground wholesale.
Ma immediatamente le autorità locali ripresero a perseguitarla, facendola arrestare più di una volta con le scuse più improbabili. Ma in qualche modo la fama dell'Essiac doveva aver attraversato la frontiera, poiché un giorno René ricevette l'invito a fare una sperimentazione del suo decotto da una clinica americana, il Brush Medical Center di Cambridge, nel Massachusetts. Il direttore della clinica, Charles Brush, era anche medico e amico personale del presidente Kennedy.
Dr. McClure, an outstanding researcher, undertook to study the effects of a drug or an herb called Essiac, and we found that it was non-toxic and did have effects in help in the treatment of cancer.
A quel punto il dottor Brush suggerì che l'Essiac fosse sottoposto ai test di tossicità per essere certificato dalla FDA come possibile cura per il cancro. Ma una volta che le erbe arrivarono allo Sloan Kettering, uno dei più importanti centri di ricerca sul cancro americani, la procedura finì per disperdersi in mille rivoli inspiegabili e in qualche modo non fu mai completata.
The results that I reported to Green Case were studies in sarcoma 180 in the mice, in which we were looking not only for possible primary inhibition of the tumor, which did not occur, but also for regressions. And there was a very small percentage in a small group of regressions, but we never had the opportunity to confirm this and to see whether we could obtain better results.
Alla fine l'Essiac non fu mai approvato dalla FDA, esattamente come aveva previsto il dottor Leonardo 30 anni prima.